guess we're going some.
Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Speedster with another Overwatch gameplay review. So today we do something a little different, and we'll go over some Ana gameplay. Just because we'll try to start doing a little bit more diversity from the main tanks, and give a little content for some of the support players. So of course we're not going to be like 100%, maybe like the best, like ML 7 or something, but you know, it's still worthwhile for like watching and learning, just because we're still gonna be playing like the right positions, and you know, communication stuff like that is still key with supports.
Honda freaking cars last forever. Toyota seem to just never die. Like honestly, the older generations of cars are like just survive forever, man. They're built
so
fast.
Right here, looks like we're doing an Orisa Ryan comp. We have Ana Moira. We have the Genji for Nano Blade.
Everything's breaking.
So here we're just going to be staying a little bit farther back from our tanks. We want to try and push in with them. So saw Genji go in, try to get the nade on that and end up blocking it. But now we're just going to play a little farther back just so we can get the value. Try to push in, so we end up going for like the sleep. Got it. Just to try and like halt their push in. And now we're trying to use a cover while we're still trying to LOS. We're just trying to push up to get us, so we just want to poke him out a little bit.
Yo, Hanzo's on right side main.
Dig's out of position, Dig's out of position.
Hey, Ryan. Oh, you want Nano? Okay. Do work with it.
So we end up getting Nano really early. We got a good purple there.
More HP. The tanks are both purple.
So now we're pushing up to long point, trying to get that purple. Since we got the purple, we want to try and hard push on with them. We're trying to get like that full on value, since the Lucio's trying, looking like he's trying to like duel us. So we want to try and stay a little bit closer to the team then, just so we can focus on trying to heal, and they're there to help us as well.
Easy,
so just like that, we stay alive for the whole fight, and by doing so, we end up getting like, you know, two good purple nades as well as heals to keep our team up. So the biggest thing with supports is trying to make sure you're staying alive.
Because
when you're dead, your team has no heals, and that's not very good. So we saw the on that right side, so we try to go for a sleep on it. Now we're trying to poke her out a little bit.
Widow dead? Oh, I just actually just owned him, bro. Out sniped.
So there we go.
Reaper slept as well.
We want to make sure we got that Ana, and then Reaper's trying to push up, so we're trying to go for the sleep, otherwise he's going to hard push into us.
We're ML7.
We are doing a little bit of a ML7 reenactment, let's be real here.
I care for the educational wrist up gameplay. So look, so you came for the wrist gameplay, and then you get the bonus of Ana.
So now we have Nano again. Yeah. We're looking to get our Nano on our Genji, so we have to make sure that he's in our sights, and we're not going to just accidentally Nano one of our teammates that walk in the way. So now they push him to the bridge, we're going to try and we'll poke them out as they're coming through, since we don't really need to heal our teammates.
Angry Reaper's above. Nano, whenever you want. Reaper slept.
So Reaper went for his ultimate there. We knew he was above us, so we were looking for our sleep, and then when he dropped, it's just like an, you know, an easy sleep right there. Then Genji wanted to go in with Nano Blade, so we give him the Nano. Now because we shut down their ultimates and then got fired of ours, I mean, push across this bridge point pretty easily.
Lucio's on me in middle.
So here we see like Lucio trying to get us on the bridge, so now we're just trying to, you know, we're a little bit out of a position there. We should have probably played all the way farther back, and then maybe Sigma wouldn't have gone on us, or if Lucio did be,
they know who the carry is, and
you know, made sure their team wouldn't get much value. So yeah, there we should have played a little bit farther back, or if we really wanted to, we'd go like all the way up into our team, so then they could save us. But either way, we end up capping the point because they put a lot of resources into killing us on the bridge. And we end up just killing them afterwards and trading really well.
Ooh.
here, pressing out low, so we went for the nade just to keep them up. Now we're playing a little bit farther back. Trying to dodge that Moira orb.
I can purple, break shield.
So we're calling their break shield just so we can get the purple, maybe starting an advantage, just because since we do have the Orisa Orion, our Orion does want to get like closer and get within that melee range onto like opposed to like their Sigma. So if we can get a purple, that it benefits our team comp, because we do want to push into them other than just staying back and poking them out like their Orisa Sig comp.
See if we can get a purple there.
So now we're getting close to our nano again. We're either going to give it to our Genji or our Ryan.
I can't see, bro. I got you.
So he wants nano. We found our Genji. Give him the nano. Now we're just trying to keep our whole team alive as he's doing work there. So as you can see, we're just trying to stay in a little bit farther, back on the corner. And we knew that usually on recontest, they're always going to go for the support. So if we stay farther back away from cart, then they don't get value. If you're staying on top of cart as support, then they're just going to look to kill you. So by staying a little bit farther back, you can, you know, they're going to bait them to go onto you. And if they don't go onto you, then they don't touch point like that ball did. So just something to think about when it's getting close to those like third point pushes and stuff like that, because everyone, every main tank, every DPS is going to look for the squishiest, easiest target to trade, and you don't want to be that guy that, you know, dies. So then it looks like on the defense we're going to be running close to the same comp. We have the Orisa, Ryan, Tracer, Junkrat, then Moira, Ana. So always be looking out on that left side, looking to poke them as they come across, look for the nades as our Ryan goes in, and yeah, just keeping them up, because we're only playing to try and like break their shield, get nade, and then engage off of that.
What? Red pandas, bitches? That is also true, B-Tittle, that's also true.
So Ryan's gonna go for that fire strike just to the door to get some extra charge. So we're gonna just throw, you know, random nade just to random nade just made up. See, maybe we get value or something out of it. But
nade I just made up, dude, almost hit him.
But now as you see, we're just playing this left corner. We don't really want to put ourselves into a spot where we can hard take damage. So if we're going to push up, then we're going to try and play behind our main tanks. So we saw them trying to push up to the right side, so we do a nade to try and get the purple. So everybody's healthy, so we need to look to heal our teammates there. Now we're looking to
if you push in, I can get a purple.
Break shield and look for purples. So there they were low, so we couldn't afford to use the nade to get a purple on them. We have to try and keep our teammates up.
Alright, we're gonna have to make some big dick plays here. They're purple on right side, purple on right side, kill that guy.
So we got the purple on the Orisa.
I'm doing that to keep you alive.
Since our Orisa was low, we end up nadoing her just to keep her alive. Because if we lose Orisa, then they might be able to like hard push on that. So that was just a using nano like defensively and stuff like that is perfectly fine to keep a teammate up. Because first point holds are the hardest when you're down a player, because they're gonna hard push that advantage.
Oh, you can't choose an emote to lock; it just gives you a random one. Oh, I didn't know that.
So now we're just trying to build our nano up again. We're playing this left side just because it has the best sight lines for us. So we see the Moira orb, we're gonna try and back out of that just so we're not taking like unnecessary damage for our teams. started pushing up, so we tried to go for the nade. Just like we ended up eating it since it was, you know, kind of a long distance one.
Wait, the bunker's
kind of like a high risk, high horde type of play there. So now we see Tyre coming in, and couldn't really dodge the Tyre there. Always gonna be looking to kill you.
Mystery Man 69 is fragging out.
So our chits is actually kind of popping off.
Mystery Man.
We need to kill the supports.
We're about to come back. This is one of the
kills. Dude, Mystery Man 69 is fragging out. Who is this guy? He's a mystery. You know the drunk guy slept?
So we saw him main like that, so we're some getting good sleep on him. And then we're gonna get back to our left side corner here. And now that we do have Nano, we can look to either keep somebody up with it or looking to hit the Genji with it. If he has Blade.
Okay, can you pull and then hold Nano, okay?
Yeah.
Oh, I have it in 2%. Okay, I should have it. I have now, whenever. Oh my god.
So, that was just a really good combo by all of us. We ended up doing a pull. Fire strike with a dash.
That's actually disgusting.
So,
nano pull, fire strike dash.
Yeah, it was that was just a really, really good coordinated combo by us there. So that's just also something that you always want to think about in those team comps and doing like old stuff like that. Always trying to make plays, set up plays. Because just by using one ult, we end up getting a wipe and, you know, built up plenty of other ults because of that. Looks like we're using Bongos in the corner, so now we're just looking to break shield. We're looking to get an anti. We're pinning our teammates with that one. So we could have been a little bit more to the corner to be able to do it. So Doom's on us, so we're trying to poke him out.
We're just the better players.
But there you go. It'll just a quick Ana game, just to show some positioning that you could do with Ana and, you know, how to play into if you have like a Reinhardt on your team. You always want to try and get in those purples, you know, helping them out. And then doing the right combo stuff. So here's that Nano Genji play. Yeah, it's just pretty nasty. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Much appreciated. And till the next video. Peace out.